Lysosomes are organelles ubiquitously distributed in eukaryotic cells. It is a membrane-bound organelle found in the cytoplasm and contains digestive enzymes. They are spherical particles with a diameter of 0.5 to 1.5 microns. Lysosome acts as the garbage disposal of the cell by breaking down cell components that are no longer needed, as well as molecules or even bacteria that are ingested by the cell. The pH in them is low, around 5. Lysosomes contain lipases, polysaccharidases, and nucleases. The lysosome enzymes are capable of breaking down all types of biological polymers, proteins, nucleic acids, carbohydrates, and lipids. Lysosomes function as the digestive system of the cell, serving both to degrade material taken up from outside the cell and to digest obsolete components of the cell itself. Interestingly, they are found in animal cells, while in plant cells, the same role is performed by the vacuole. The name lysosome is derived from the Greek word lysis, which means dissolution or destruction, and soma, which means body. They are frequently nicknamed suicide bags or suicide sacs by cell biologists due to their role in autolysis. Lysosomes were discovered by the Belgian cytologist Christian Didieu in 1955. In their simplest form, lysosomes are visualized as dense spherical vacuoles, but they can display considerable variation in size and shape as a result of differences in the materials that have been taken up for digestion. Lysosomes thus represent morphologically diverse organelles defined by the common function of degrading intracellular material. Interestingly, the number of lysosomes in cells varies with structure and functions. Many human cells contain hundreds of lysosomes, while phagocytic cells often contain thousands of lysosomes. However, mature human erythrocytes, red blood cells, do not contain any lysosomes. Lysosomes are particularly abundant in secretory cells, such as epithelial cells, and in phagocytic cells. For example, there are many lysosomes in liver cells, two of the main functions of the liver being, first, secretion of bile and bile salts, and second, phagocytosis of bacteria and dead or foreign materials. There are also many lysosomes in cells of the kidneys, performing diversified functions. Deficiency of some of the lysosomic enzymes leads to specific lysosomal storage diseases, such as Tay-Sachs, Gaucher, and Hunter diseases. The lysosome is a type of membrane-bound organelle that is present in animal cells, ranging in diameter from approximately 50 nanometer to 1 micrometer. Lysosomes have a single outer membrane consisting of a phospholipid bilayer and contain acid hydrolases, which are enzymes capable of breaking down macromolecules. The outer surface is formed by a single membrane, a phospholipid bilayer, that can fuse with some other membrane-bound organelles. A single lysosome contains several enzyme molecules. The enzyme contained within lysosomes are known collectively as acid hydrolases and work best in acidic environment, that is at low pH. The interior of lysosomes is acidic, pH 4.8 to 5, compared with slightly basic pH 7.2 intracellular fluid, which is also called cytosol, that surrounds organelles such as lysosomes within the cell. Recent work suggests that there are two types of lysosomes, secretory lysosomes and conventional ones. Secretory lysosomes are found, although not exclusively, in different cells of the immune system, such as T lymphocytes derived from hematopoietic cell line. Secretory lysosomes are a combination of conventional lysosomes and secretory granules. They differ from conventional lysosomes in that they contain the particular secretory product of the cell in which they reside. T lymphocytes, for example, contain secretory products that can attack both virus infected and tumor cells. The mature secretory lysosomes move within the cytoplasm to the plasma membrane. Genetically driven disorders of secretory lysosomes can lead to impaired platelet synthesis, a type of immunodeficiency, and hypopigmentation. Conventional lysosomes. Lysosomes reside in the cell as reusable organelles, and when cell division takes place, each daughter cell receives a number of lysosomes. Conventional lysosomes are involved in the dismantling and recycling of various substrates presented to them through endocytosis, phagocytosis, and by autophagosomes. They are responsible for returning many amino acids to the system. It is thought that the reservoir of chemicals in the conventional lysosome can be topped up by supplies from the Golgi apparatus. The chemicals are manufactured in the endoplasmic reticulum, modified in the Golgi apparatus, and transported to the lysosomes in vesicles as sealed droplets. Lysosomes digest unused and or threatening content that is present in the cell. In retrospect, lysosomes recycle the cell's organic material in a process known as autophagy. It also recycles waste products such as fats, carbohydrates, proteins, and other macromolecules into simple compounds, which are then utilized as new materials in the cytoplasm. The recycling of waste product is in large part due to about 40 different types of hydrolytic enzymes that are engineered by the endoplasmic reticulum and modified by Golgi apparatus. Endocytosis. One of the major functions of lysosomes is the digestion of material taken up from outside the cell by endocytosis. However, the role of lysosomes in the digestion of material taken up by endocytosis relates not only to the function of lysosomes, but also to their formation. In particular, lysosomes are formed by the fusion of transport vesicles budded from the trans-Golgi network with endosomes, which contain molecules taken up by endocytosis at the plasma membrane. The formation of lysosomes thus represents an intersection between the secretory pathway, through which lysosomal proteins are processed, and the endocytic pathway, through which extracellular molecules are taken up at the cell surface. Material from outside the cell is taken up in cladrin-coated endocytic vesicles, which bud from the plasma membrane and then fuse with early endosomes. Membrane components are then recycled to the plasma membrane and the early endosomes gradually mature into late endosomes, which are the precursors to lysosomes. One of the important changes during endosome maturation is the lowering of internal pH to about 5.5, which plays a key role in the delivery of lysosomal acid hydrolysis from the trans-Golgi network, phagocytosis. The process of phagocytosis was discovered by Metchnikoff in the early 1890s. The term phagocytosis denotes the engulfment and digestion of whole cells. Phagocytosis is one of the type of endocytosis. In phagocytosis, a cell's plasma membrane expands around the particulate material, which may include whole pathogenic microorganisms, to form large vesicle called phagosomes. Most phagocytosis is conducted by specialized cells such as blood monocytes, neutrophils, and tissue macrophages. Most cell types are capable of other forms of endocytosis, such as receptor mediated endocytosis, in which extracellular molecules are internalized after binding by specific cellular receptors, and pinocytosis, the process by which cells take up fluid from surrounding medium along with any molecule contained in it. Phagocytosis occurs in 5 steps, namely uptake, endosome formation, phagolysosome formation, lysis, diffusion of digested material, and exocytosis. In order to uptake microorganisms, pseudopodia develop around the microbe and takes up the microbe to form endosome. Endosome again combines with lysosomal fraction to form phagoendosome. When the pH of phagoendosome is changed to acidic, lysosomal enzyme activated and they lyse microbes. After lysis, digested materials are passed through diffusion into cellular components. Undigested materials during phagocytosis will be excreted out, autophagy. Lysosomes are also responsible for autophagy, the gradual turnover of cells' own components. The first step of autophagy appears to be the enclosure of an organelle such as a mitochondria in membrane derived from the yarn. The resulting vesicle in autophagosome then fuses with a lysosome and its contents are digested. Autophagy is responsible for the gradual turnover of cytoplasmic organelles. The term autophagy covers 3 processes: microautophagy, macroautophagy, and chaperone mediated autophagy. Microautophagy is the transfer of cytosolic components into the lysosome by direct invagination of the lysosomal membrane and subsequent budding of vesicles into the lysosomal lumen. While macroautophagy involves formation of a double membrane structure called the autophagosome, which sequesters cytosolic material and delivers it to the lysosome for degradation. Although this degradation can be selective, such as specific removal of damaged mitochondria, sparing normal functioning ones. On the other hand, degradation of soluble cytosolic proteins is non-selective. chaperone mediated autophagy is characterized by its selective regarding the specific substrates cytosolic proteins degraded. Autolysis. Autolysis refers to the digestion of own cells by the lysosomes. In autolysis, the lysosome digests its own cell. Hence, autolysis is also called as cellular autophagy. In this process, the lysosome ruptures inside its cell and released enzymes digest and degrade the cell. As lysosome kills its own cell, it is called as suicidal bag. Autolytic cell degradation is uncommon in living adult organisms and usually occurs in injured cells or dying tissues. Autolysis is initiated by the cell's lysosome releasing digestive enzymes into the cytoplasm. These enzymes are, however, released due to the cessation of active processes in the cell, not as an active process. In other words, though autolysis resembles the active process of digestion of nutrients by live cells, the dead cells are not actively digesting themselves, as it often claimed and as the synonym self-digestion of autolysis seem to imply. Autolysis occurs during amphibian metamorphosis and insect metamorphosis. During amphibian metamorphosis, the cells in tail, gills, etcetera are digested by autolysis. Similarly, during menstruation in mammals, the cells in uterine epithelium are lysed by autolysis. Proteolysis of cellular proteins. The other major pathway of protein degradation in eukaryotic cells involve the uptake of proteins by lysosomes. Lysosomes contain an array of digestive enzymes, including several proteases. The containment of proteases and other digestive enzymes within lysosomes prevents uncontrolled degradation of the contents of the cell. Therefore, in order to be degraded by lysosomal proteolysis, cellular proteins must first be taken up by lysosomes. One pathway for this uptake of cellular proteins, autophagy, involves the formation of vesicles, autophagosomes, in which small areas of cytoplasm or cytosolic organelles are enclosed in membrane derived from the endoplasmic reticulum. These vesicles then fuse with lysosomes, and the degradative lysosomal enzymes digest their contents. The uptake of proteins into autophagosomes appears to be non-selective, so it results in the eventual slow degradation of long-lived cytoplasmic proteins. The proteins degraded by lysosomal proteases under these conditions contain amino acid sequences similar to the broad consensus sequences lysine, phenylalanine, glutamate, arginine and glutamine, which presumably targets them to lysosomes. A member of the HSP70 family of molecular chaperones is also required for the lysosomal degradation of these proteins, presumably acting to unfold the polypeptide chains during their transport across the lysosomal membrane. The proteins susceptible to degradation by this pathway are thought to be normally long-lived but dispensable proteins. Under starvation conditions, these proteins are sacrificed to provide amino acids and energy, allowing some basic metabolic processes to continue. We shall now see the formation of lysosomes in animal cells. The Golgi apparatus forms tiny vesicles that separate or bud from the ends of Golgi cisternae. Vesicles formed in this way that contain hydrolytic enzymes are called as primary lysosomes. Secondary lysosomes are formed when primary lysosomes fuse with other membrane bound vesicles. Upon leaving the Golgi apparatus, the lysosomal enzyme filled vesicle fuses with a late endosome, a relatively acidic organelle with an approximately pH of 5.5. This acidic environment causes dissociation of the lysosomal enzymes from the mannose-6-phosphate receptors. The enzymes are packed into vesicles for further transport to established lysosomes. The late endosome itself can eventually grow into a mature lysosome, as evidenced by the transport of endosomal membrane components from the lysosomes back to the endosome. Lysosomes are organelles that are surrounded by a single membrane and contain many hydrolases that are most active at an acidic pH. The pH within the lysosomal lumen is usually maintained between 5 and 5.5. Lysosomes account for 1 to 15% of cell volume and of cell protein in mammalian cells. This variability depends on cell type and physiological status. Enzymes in lysosomal lumen are targeted to that location by mannose-6-phosphate carbohydrate modifications in case of mammalian cell lysosomes, or by linear peptide sequences for the yeast vacuole. Peripheral lysosomal membrane proteins generally interact strong with one or more integral membrane proteins and or lipids. Lysosomes are responsible for most protein degradation in liver and kidney and phagocytosis of bacteria and foreign materials. Deficiency of some of the lysosomic enzymes leads to specific lysosomal storage diseases such as Tay-Sachs, Gaucher and Hunter diseases. Lysosomes also contribute to maintaining cellular homeostasis, and thus malfunctions in this organelle have a direct impact on cell behavior and fate. Lysosomes may also be involved in other cellular processes such as albinism and aging.